Yo, 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 what is up, guys? Hope you guys are doing well. It's your boy Faris, and in today's video, I'm going to be going over 5 side hustles you guys can start today that can help you generate some extra money every single month and possibly cover some of your monthly expenses. The best part is these side hustles are scalable, meaning that you guys can turn these into a full-time income. I know this because I do this myself, and I'm making a decent amount of money every single month. Now, these aren't your generic side hustles of taking thousands of surveys just to get $10 and wasting hours of your time. These are unique side hustles if implemented correctly. You guys can make a good amount of money with. Now, I know there's legit thousands of videos on YouTube on different ways to make money, but the thing is, like I said, these side hustles are unique, and if you guys can do this correctly, you guys can make a good amount of money with at the end of this year 2020 and in the year 2021. So you already know what to do. Smash that like button, subscribe if you guys haven't already. This channel is all about finance, entrepreneurship, money, investing, all that good stuff, and make sure you hit the bell notification icon so you know every time I release a new video. So with that being said, let's see what these 5 side hustles are. The first side hustle is taking 3D virtual tours of homes that are listed for sale. Now, this is a newer side hustle I haven't seen many people talk about, but essentially what you're doing is making a 3D format of a tour so everyone can see it from their computer screen or their phone. Now, this is an added benefit to the people buying the house because they can see everything about the house without actually going in person. They can see which room leads to the next or an aerial view of the whole room. And this is also a benefit to the real estate agent listing the property because they can get more leads through it because this is a newer technology and people can see this new feature on the listing. So what you can do is market your services to real estate agents or people selling their homes. What I would do is go to websites like Zillow.com, Trulia, or Realtor and scroll through the listings and see which houses don't have a 3D virtual tour option. And judging by the houses that don't, just shoot the real estate agent or the seller a message saying, hey, this is what I do. This is a service I provide. I can help you generate more leads while also helping you sell your home faster. So how can you guys do this? There's actually a company out there called Matterport, which specializes in 3D virtual tours. You can buy a camera from them, or you guys can actually use your phone to make the 3D virtual tours, and they actually guide you through step by step on how you guys can create your virtual tours. It's really simple to do. So how much can you make from the side hustle? You can easily make anywhere in between $50 to $100 per 3D render, and each house will probably take you about an hour depending on the size of the home. It's probably best to price yourself on the lower end when starting out though, just so you can build out your clientele and get your name out there. The best part is if an agent likes your work for the first time, their job essentially is to sell houses. So anytime they sell another house or have a new listing, they'll call you to make a 3D render for, which is consistent income for you. Now, if you guys want to check out Matterport, I'll leave a link to it down below. It's an amazing website. It guides you through exactly step by step on how you guys can make a 3D vendor. Now, you might be wondering, why can't the real estate agents just do this themselves? The reason is because majority of the real estate agents are much older and they think this technology is more sophisticated and they don't want to learn it. That's where you can come in, and it's very simple, and do it for them and make a good amount of money doing it. The second side hustle is flipping things, whether it is shoes, phones, designer brands. If you can research trends and see which things will go up in value, you can buy them for retail and sell them for resale and make a profit. So what I'm going to do is, recently I just bought a pair of shoes. They haven't come in the mail yet, so I'll show you on my phone. I'll show you how much I paid for them, how much resale is, and how much I'm going to be making profit. So let's head on into my phone. So this is the shoe that I bought. I paid $200 for it. It's the Jordan 3 Fragments. I think they released like last week. Like I said, I haven't got it in the mail yet, but it's like iconic shoe, the Fragments. It's a pretty big thing in the Nike space, so I'm super lucky I got it. So what I'm going to do, so after taxes, I paid almost $212. So what I'm going to do is go into StockX. Now this is where I usually sell all my sneakers. I'm going to type in the shoe, which is the Jordan 3 Fragments, and pull it up over here. So what I'm gonna do is, I got a size 13. I'm gonna change it to a size 13 and go to the highest bid. And if I click size 13, what StockX does is it subtracts all the fees, and then my total payout would be $385. So if I go to my calculator and I do 385 minus 212, I'm gonna be left with $173 profit for selling this shoe. But what I'm gonna do is actually hold it, because as I said, this is a more of an iconic type of shoe. I know the price is going to go up in value, so I'm gonna hold it for probably a couple more months, and when the price is a little higher, that's when I'm going to sell it. So as you saw on my phone, I use an app called StockX to sell my shoes. Basically what they are is a middleman, so they connect buyers with sellers. So for example, let's say I have this shoe and I want to sell it to someone. I can put up a price. So let's say I want to sell mine for $500. A buyer can come in and see that I have it listed for $500, and they can accept that bid, and the sale will go through. And then vice versa, let's say I want to buy this shoe and I only want to pay $480 max. And let's say you guys have the shoe, you guys have the opportunity to accept my bid right away and it'll go through. I'll pay the $480 and you guys will send me the shoe. And then what you would do is send the shoe to StockX, they'll verify it's real and sell it and ship it to the buyer. It's an amazing app. You do have to pay for, they do take a decent amount of fee, but you get the peace of mind. You don't have to constantly worry about lowballers or meeting up with random people to sell an expensive shoe because there's a safety hazard. It's just an amazing app and that's what I use. So far, I've made over $2,300 just by reselling shoes and I do this on the side. I don't do this full time. Anytime a major release or a hype shoe is releasing, I'll go for the shoe and try to cop and make some profit reselling. The hard part is for shoes that have higher resale, usually have a lower supply of them, so it's harder for you to cop. I usually only go for shoes on the Nike sneakers app because, like I said, I do this on the side, so it's easier and the UI is a lot simpler. What you can do is just set up alerts anytime a hype shoe is releasing and you can go for them. Now Nike, what they do is for certain shoes, they have a raffle, so you have 10 minutes to enter and it's random and you can pick that way. Majority of the releases are first come first serve. I usually miss about 9 out of 10 times. Sometimes I get lucky, but if you can get lucky on a hype release that has a lot of resale, your 9 other times that you miss will make up for the profit you'll make off that one shoe. The third side hustle you can start is becoming a property manager. Now if you've always been interested into real estate or don't have the money to get into it, a property manager is an awesome thing you guys can do. Essentially what they do is manage the property of landlords. So think about it. Landlords have a lot of rental properties and they just can't keep track of everything that's going on. They can't keep track of everything that needs to be replaced. So what they do is get a property manager. So how it works is you have the landlord up here who owns the property. What they do is get a property manager and then the tenant is down here who lives there. So the tenant relays all the information about the house back to the property manager and certain things the property manager tells to the landlord. So the landlord doesn't hear about every little thing and they can have a peace of mind because they'll have other stuff to worry about. So the property manager can get paid two ways. Either you can get a fixed fee every single month for managing the property, or you can get a certain percentage of what the property is renting for. So let's say the property is renting for $2,000 and the landlord agrees to give you 5%. You would get $100 every single month for managing the property. But remember, this is all estimates. It all depends on how much the landlord is willing to give you. So let's say the landlord has multiple properties. You can manage them and make a good amount of money every single month by managing his properties. Now, this is something you don't need a lot of experience for. As long as you have basic people skills and you're really interested into real estate, this will be perfect for you. So how can you find these properties to manage? So I suggest going to websites like Facebook Marketplace or Craigslist and looking up places for sale or houses for rent and call up the landlords that listed them and tell them you're a property manager in the area and you'll love to manage their properties. And you guys can build out an agreement and go from there. The fourth side hustle you can start is having an ATM or vending machine business. Now this does require an investment, but it can also be the most rewarding. Now if you watch my videos, you guys know I have my own ATM or vending machines and you guys can check those out. I'll leave a link to them down below. I go into full depth on how you guys can start your businesses as well. But essentially, let's say you guys want to start an ATM business. All you have to do is put it into a location such as a bar or a barbershop, and every time someone uses it, you get a surcharge, which is your profit. So let's say your surcharge is $3 and you get 5 transactions a day. That's $15 a day, $105 a week, and over $500 a month in profit from one ATM. And let's say you do the same thing with a vending machine. All you have to do is put it into a location such as like a laundromat or a clinic and just fill it up with snacks, and you get paid anytime someone buys a snack. These are both great sources of passive income. You know, it's not much maintenance. All you have to do is replenish the cash or the snacks in the vending machine. Essentially, there's much more to both these business models. So as I said, if you guys are interested, I'll leave a link to my previous videos on them down below. I would love if you check them out as well. The fifth side hustle is, I'm sure you've seen a lot of people post online that they're making thousands of dollars a day with it, but it is dropshipping. Essentially, you're buying a product for cheaper and selling it at a higher price, but you don't see the product. You ship it straight from the supplier to the customer's house. Now, this is a huge industry right now and there's a lot of competition around it. So can you still make money with it? The answer is plain and simple, yes. There will always be people looking to buy, but it's going to be a lot harder because there's a lot more competition out there. Even if you don't make any money, you'll learn a lot of valuable skills such as Facebook ads, copywriting, website design, all skills that are very valuable to learn for your future. All you have to do is create a website on Shopify.com, You're gonna import your products, whatever you choose to sell, from AliExpress using an app called Oberlo. That'll just take the product page from AliExpress and put it on your website. You're gonna make your website look all presentable and good, so anytime someone goes on your website, they don't think it's a scam and they're, you know, they feel comfortable buying from there. Once you have your store looking presentable, you're gonna need traffic. So what you're gonna do is run either Facebook ads, Google ads, or influential marketing to get traffic to your website, and hopefully people on your website will convert into buying something that you're selling. So I'm not gonna go too in depth on this topic because there are literally thousands of other videos on YouTube where you guys can learn on this. And to be quite frank, they're probably more knowledgeable than me on this topic. So feel free to check out those other YouTube videos. But that is it, guys. These are 5 side hustles you guys can start today that can help you generate extra money every single month and possibly make you a good amount of money in the year 2021. Now, it's not gonna be easy. You're gonna have to put in a lot of work, but that's the case with anything that you do. So I wish you the best of luck. If you made it this far, be sure to subscribe. Like if you guys haven't already, it helps the YouTube algorithm show my videos to more people. But with that being said, I'll see you in the next video, and as always, keep hustling.